Ever wish you could stream to TikTok, YouTube, and Twitch simultaneously without a complicated setup? Well, Streamelements just dropped a game-changing update that makes multi-streaming ridiculously easy, with a twist we haven't seen before. This may very well be the best multi-stream OBS plugin in 2024. In this video, I'll show you how to install Streamelements Live, access the beta update, and set up all of your preferred platforms. Be sure to check the description below for chapters on each section so that you can easily follow along at your preferred pace. But before we get into it, be sure to subscribe now and don't miss out on more tools and tips, just like the one coming your way now. So Streamelements just released a beta update for their OBS plugin, which now allows you to multi-stream, set up individual canvases for each platform, and engage with all of your chats through a multi-chat feature. These features are 100% free and run locally on your system. Streamelements developers work tirelessly to optimize these new features to run without being too demanding on your CPU or GPU. However, it is still recommended that your hardware be at least 2019 and onwards. You will also need to consider the bitrate you have set up on OBS to ensure that you have enough internet bandwidth to support multiple streams. For instance, if you're running two streams at 6,000 kilobytes per second, you would need to have at least 12,000 kilobytes per second upload speeds in order to support them. But it's more than likely you're gonna need even more than that. For those that do find that their internet or hardware can't handle this currently, check out this video I did on Casterlabs Multicaster, which allows you to send a single stream out to multiple platforms using their services with no extra load on the user's PC or internet services. With Streamelements' latest update, you can add any platform they currently support, such as Twitch, YouTube, YouTube Shorts, TikTok, X, formerly known as Twitter, Trovo, and any other custom RTMP destination like Kick or Instagram. You can add as many platforms as your computer and connection can handle. Let me know down in the comments what platforms you are most excited to stream to and which ones you would like to see added. My favorite new feature, however, is the ability to create as many canvases as you'd like aside from your main canvas. This comes in handy in the case that you would like to set up your TikTok and YouTube short streams to look different or utilize separate sources and audio tracks. You can create as many horizontal or vertical canvases as you would like. To use this service, you'll have to download and set up the Streamelements Live plugin, which we're going to get into now. First, we're going to go over to streamelements.com/se.live, or you can click on the link down in the description. From here, we're going to select the file and let it download. Once that's downloaded, you'll run the installer and select which folder you want to download Streamelements Live to and proceed. It's important to note that if you haven't already downloaded OBS Studio, the file installer will allow you to prompt it to install OBS as well during that installation. Once you're finished, let's open OBS Studio. If it's your first time running Streamelements Live, you'll be prompted on OBS to log into your preferred service. Once logged in, we will need to change Streamelements Live from the default version to the beta version. You can do so by clicking the Streamelements menu, hovering over se.live versions, and selecting the beta version. Click yes, and then it will begin installing the beta version. Once that is finished, you're all done, and it's time to set up your multi-streams. First, we'll want to set up each of our outputs. Outputs are the streaming services in which you'll want to send your streams to. You can do this in the multi-stream panel found at the bottom right. Here, you can see all of your connected services. In order to multi-stream to any of them, all you have to do is flip a switch. If you don't see one of the services you would like to stream to, all you have to do is click the plus symbol at the bottom left and select the platform you want to add. Then all you need to do is connect to the service. If you're using a custom RTMP, input the output name, server URL, and the stream key. Once it's added to the panel, you'll see the channel name and which canvas it's using. To get more detailed settings, you can click the three dots to the right and select the setting option. From there, you'll see outputs, canvas settings, and broadcast settings. On this menu, you can select connect on the platforms you desire to enable. From here, you can also choose which desired audio track you would like to send out to the platform. This could come in handy for instances such as not sending out copyright music or limiting which stream alerts are going to get sent where. From here, we're going to jump over to broadcast settings where you can set your titles and categories all before hitting the start streaming button. Now let's talk about TikTok. By selecting the TikTok option here, you can easily connect your account. Even if you don't already have access to TikTok Live, by logging into your account with Streamelements plugin, you can take advantage of an expedited review process that they have secured with TikTok. Once you're logged in and have gained access to TikTok Live, the toggle on the panel will flip to the on position. No more having to join TikTok agencies to get a stream key that has to be updated each time you go live on OBS, and no more having to utilize that TikTok Live Studio. We all know we don't like it. This is great, but there's still one more step to be able to stream to TikTok in a vertical format. With that being said, let's create our first additional canvas. Click on any of the three dot menus, go down to Canvas, and select Create a New Canvas. A new window will pop up allowing you to name the canvas and choose a resolution. In this case, we'll want to select 1080 by 1920 option and then click OK. With that, you have a new canvas. From here, you can see a preview of what the audience will see and add any scenes like you would have in your primary OBS canvas. After adding a scene, you'll want to click the three dot menu that scene and then choose add source to add whatever sources you would like. Now that our canvases have been added, let's go back to our canvas settings and check that out. In the drop-down menu, you can select which canvas you want to configure. From here, we can adjust the name and resolution, see which outputs are connected to that canvas, and in the advanced settings, you can select from your available methods of encoding. Now, don't forget to go back and link those new canvas scenes to your primary canvas scenes for a seamless transition without having to do anything additional when navigating back and forth while live. With that, you're ready to go live. Once you click that Start Streaming button, a new window will pop up asking you to confirm the stream titles and categories for each of your connected services. Once you're live, you will even see an indicator that that platform is live next to each of the services in the panel. Last but not least, pop open your multi-chat and TikTok chat and you're all set. Thanks for watching today's video. Don't forget to check the description for the link to download Streamelements Live plugin and start your multi-streaming journey today. Join our community of streamers and be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to stay up to date on our latest tools and tips. I look forward to seeing you all live on multiple platforms.